Okay. Nice and simple. Let me tell you what happened, everything I can remember, in order. And then when I'm done, if there's anything you want to ask, I'll do my best to answer. How's that sound? So, Friday, a week ago, me and the team, we go for drinks at the cabin. That's the pub near Latimer Road, the one that stays open late on a Friday and Saturday, turns into a bit of a club. So that's me, Andy, that's Andrew Flanagan from finance, and then my sales team, that's Kelly, Sanjay, and then, you know, Sarah. As in Sarah Macklin. I get the first round, my way of marking the end of the week. We drink those, that's the rule, and then whoever wants to stay, stays, and whoever wants to go, they can go. It's the same every Friday, nobody is forced to do anything. And just after 9, Sanjay and Kelly go home separately, so that leaves me, Andy, and Sarah, yes? You know, we're still there, the three of us, when the club bit starts, whenever that starts, midnight, something like that. And this probably doesn't help me, but it's true. We're all a bit worse for wear by this point. You know, Sarah is, definitely. And she's new, and I'm thinking she still wants to show us she's a laugh. Not show us she's a laugh, show us she's not a laugh, if that makes sense. You know, I'm pissed, because I just am, that's allowed. Andy's well gone because it's Friday and because he works in finance and that's nobody's idea of a fun week. Oh, and nobody's eaten anything either. So I start thinking we should leave, all of us. But then Sarah says she wants to stay, and because she says that, Andy wants to stay when Andy's too drunk to stand up. But Sarah says she wants to talk to me about how the new job's going. One of those serious conversations people want to have when they're drunk. You know, opportunities, promotions, shouting over the music. You know, I respect you. I want to make my way up the company, you know. Ambitious. I'm like, you're doing great and all that. I mean, she's doing okay. She's only been there a month. She made a few sales. Not as much as some, but, you know. And then I look over at Andy, and I decide it's time Andy went home. Yeah, not because of anything between me and her, but because it's time we all went home. So we get in a cab. We drop him off. He's first. If you do the route from there, he is first. You mean you can check that. And then there's just the two of us. And she wants to get another drink to keep talking. Her suggestion. But that's not going to work, because the only place near there that's still open at that time is the cabin, the place we've just come from. So she says, she asks, where do I live? Can we get a drink back at mine? Her idea. Yeah, don't get any funny ideas, she tells me. Loud and clear. This is platonic. That's the message. Now, God knows why that's the message, given the reasons we're here, but that was what was said at the time. And is understood by me loud and clear. She says she wants my advice, please, you know, because you're where I want to be in 5 years' time, all her. And so we do. We drink wine at mine, music. I'm on the sofa, she's on the chair. She gets up, goes to the loo, comes back in again, sits back down, but now she's on the sofa next to me, close. Right up here, close, in like that. And I don't mind it. I'll be honest, I don't mind it. I mean, she's there, she's flirting, making all the running, that's up to her. She's drinking, she's choosing the music. She says she's gonna kiss me because she likes this song. She kisses me, you know, I kiss her back. I'm not saying that I don't. But then it gets to the point where she's so pissed and the song she's picking is so loud and so not what anyone needs to be hearing, that I book her an Uber. Now, you've got that from before. I get her an Uber, it's on my account. But when it comes, she won't take it. Now, I can't get her to go. She sits back down, one for the road, and she's fit, yes. And I'm not uninterested. We end up in the bedroom, and, in the bed, on the bed. I never said we didn't. We do it once, 1.5 times. Badly, probably. But we both wanted to do it, and that's the point. And in the morning, she's gone, which is okay. We don't speak on the Saturday or the Sunday, and on the Monday afternoon, when she's back in the office, neither of us mentions it. It's not until today, that's basically a week later, that your lot turn up and start with all this shit. And this shit's gonna ruin me.
Do you want to say it, or shall I?
No. You can go.
Okay. Alex, we don't believe you.